Hello and welcome to OptinMonster. We make it easy to create campaigns that convert your website traffic into leads and customers. In this video, I'll show you how to create your first OptinMonster campaign. If you haven't done so already, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell. Now, let's get started. I'll begin with the assumption that you've already installed the OptinMonster WordPress plugin and connected your site with your OptinMonster account. If not, check out our video and documentation on this topic. OptinMonster offers several campaign types to help you craft targeted offers. You can select from pop-up, floating bar, full screen, inline, slide-in, and if you have a growth subscription, gamified. For this example, I'll choose pop-up. Next, you can choose a template from the hundreds of designs that are proven to convert and simply edit the copy and configure the display rules to meet your specific needs, or select a campaign from our Playbooks library. With Playbooks, we've completely taken the guesswork out of campaign creation. We studied the conversion strategies of the most successful, inspiring brands in the world, then replicated those strategies for you in our well-designed, pre-configured campaigns. Each playbook showcases the original source of inspiration and the real-world proven results our customers generated through its implementation. For new users, we'll present you with recommendations for your particular category and goal based on the answers you provided during the onboarding survey. However, you can also filter and search for specific playbooks too. Now, the great thing about playbooks is that they truly are plug and play. We've created the design, written the copy, and configured the display rules for you. All you have to do is select Use Playbook, check the campaign notes section to see what specific areas you need to personalize, and you're ready to publish. The best part is, playbooks are available for all subscription plans. If your subscription doesn't include the powerful rules used in the suggested playbook, we'll automatically replace those rules with the best option available. For today's example, I'll head back over to the template library and select a campaign there. When browsing the campaign templates, you can use the filter to help narrow your options. For this example, I'll select the basic template. You can click Preview to see an example, or click Use Template to select it. Next, give the campaign a descriptive title and click Start Building. Next, you'll land on the Design tab where you can edit your campaign. From the footer menu, you can switch between editing the various views. The opt-in view collects your visitor's information, and the success view appears after your visitor completes the opt-in form. On plus and higher plans, you'll also have the option to add a yes/no view, which allows you to create a two-step opt-in. Also from the footer menu, you can import the content from one view to another within this campaign, or import the content from any of the views of any of your other campaigns, switch to editing another campaign, and edit the campaign's details. When editing the content of a view, you can edit text in line and drag and drop other elements, such as images, buttons, and countdown timers, to name a few, onto your campaign. Simply point and click to edit any block, and the menu on the left will update so you can make your changes. For example, when you edit the form fields block, you can customize the form collecting your visitor's information to gather all the information you need from your leads. In a later step, you can map those fields directly to the appropriate fields in your email service provider or customer relationship management software. With a wide range of available blocks, OptinMonster makes it easy to design forms and pop-ups tailored to your website and audience. So when building your campaign, be sure to refer to our complete guide on choosing the right block for your campaign. When you're finished editing the content and design of your campaign, head over to Display Rules. OptinMonster's display rules truly are its secret sauce. You can create rule sets, a group of rules that defines the condition that allows or prevents your campaign from appearing, that are as simple or as complex as you need. And yes, a rule set can be as simple as a single rule, but you'll probably want to get a little more specific with your targeting than that. And you can do that by combining rules in a group using all or any one operators. If you use the any one operator, the group of rules will be true if any single one of the conditions in the group is true. However, if you use the all operator, the group of rules will only be true if all of the conditions in the group are true at the same time. For example, the default rule set is a simple group of rules using the all operator to show the opt-in view when the visitor has been on any page for at least 5 seconds. Taking this one step further, you can create multiple groups of rules within each rule set. Groups of rules are linked by AND, meaning that for the rule set to be true, all groups of rules must be true at the same time. So for example, let's add a group of rules to the default group. I'll add an exit intent condition as well as a scroll distance condition. I'll set this group to use the AnyOne operator. Now, I've just created a rule set that will show the opt-in view of the campaign when the user has been on any page for at least 5 seconds, and the user is either attempting to leave or has scrolled at least 15% of the page. So with just a few clicks, I've created a pretty specific scenario, and this just barely scratches the surface of what OptinMonster's display rules can do. We've got rules for just about every scenario you can dream up. We've grouped our most popular rules for quick access, but you also have rules specifically for who, when, and where, as well as rules for on-site retargeting based on user behavior on your site, and we even have rules specifically for e-commerce. If you ever need a little more information about what each rule is or does, we've provided a link to our documentation, as well as a quick explainer video for each rule. When working with a rule in a group, you can quickly duplicate it or hide it. When you hide a rule in a group, it removes it as a qualifying condition without deleting it. Additionally, you can drag and drop rules to reorder them or move them to other groups. To add yet another layer of customization, you can even create multiple rule sets with completely different rules for each campaign. Now, only one single rule set needs to have all of its rules passed for the campaign to display, meaning that rule sets are connected with the AnyOne operator in a technical sense. So, as you can see, there are countless display rule configurations, allowing you to create simple or complex rule sets based on your specific needs. And once you've created your rule set, you can even save it and import it to your other campaigns. This can be especially useful if you have different campaigns for various seasons, sales, or holidays, but use the same or similar rule sets. Instead of recreating the rule sets each time, you can simply save and import. Now let's move on to actions. Here, you can choose how often the campaign appears to visitors by configuring the campaign cookies. For example, if someone has closed and not converted the campaign, you can determine if or when the visitor sees the campaign again, and likewise for someone who has converted the campaign. And if your site uses subdomains, you can apply these rules there as well. And if you have a plus or higher subscription, you can add monster effects, animation, and sound to your pop-up campaigns to catch your visitors' attention and increase conversions. Finally, let's move on to the summary. Here, you can review all the display rule settings you've configured for this campaign. If everything looks good, you can move on to integrations, where you'll connect OptinMonster to your email service provider. If you've already set up a default integration in your account settings, you'll see it here. Otherwise, you can search for your provider and connect to it now. We've provided a link to our documentation for the instructions on connecting to your specific integration. If you don't have an email marketing service set up, you can connect to Monster Leads, our in-house lead storage system, which allows you to get started gathering leads. In fact, even if you have an email marketing service, we recommend connecting Monster Leads as a backup to your email service provider. After you've connected your integration, you'll need to map any fields you added to your opt-in form beyond the default name, email, and phone fields, which are mapped to the default fields in your email service provider automatically. Now, each provider handles this a bit differently, but again, we've documented all those details and conveniently linked to the article specific to your provider here. After you've set up your email service provider, head over to Analytics. This is where you connect your campaigns to Google Analytics for more advanced analytics data. OptinMonster Analytics will automatically track basic analytics data, such as impressions, conversions, and highest converting pages. And finally, head over to Publish. This is where you'll do a final review of all the details of your campaign and publish it to your site. Check the right columns checklist for any gray circles next to items, letting you know that something is missing or may need to be fixed before publishing. If everything looks good, click Publish and then click Save. Next, close the builder to return to the output settings page in the OptinMonster for WordPress plugin. You can further target where your campaigns appear using the advanced settings. Remember that your campaign must meet all of the conditions you set in display rules, as well as the conditions you select in the output settings, before it can appear. When you're finished configuring your output settings, select who should see the campaign, all visitors, or only logged in visitors, under visibility and status. Change the status from draft to published, and click Save Changes. And that's it! We've successfully created and launched our first OptinMonster campaign. If you have any questions, browse through our helpful documentation, or for further assistance, you can submit a support ticket, and we'd be happy to help.